Hey yo, it's Noku2 here with another comic haul. First, as always, I want to thank everyone who has taken their time to watch my video and post a comment. Well, let's just get started. So, you know, what you have here in front of you is one of the most iconic covers in Silver Age Marvel. Silver Surfer number 4. One of my all-time favorite covers by Buscema. Reproduced, homaged many times over. And I've shown this comic before. This is, I bought this, as I talked about in the video before. It's a 8-0. However, when I look at it, you know, it definitely could be pressed. There's a little indentation I think you can see in the cover there. Maybe Kane on the with the Mylar bag around the case, but I mean it's a beautiful sharp cover. And when I bought it online many years ago, the store that was advertising it thought it was undergraded, and I think it's undergraded also. I think it's definitely higher than an 8.0, easily an 8.5, maybe even pressed it could get higher as a 9. But again, not why I'm showing that comic. I am showing this comic because I've shown it before, because I got this set. I waited for several months for it. It came in 2 different releases, but bam, look at that. When I saw the pre-order release for that, for this statue, 2 pieces, high resin, with, let's zoom in on that a little bit more. With Thor doing his pose, holding his hammer on the Rainbow Bridge. This came as 1 piece. Then 2 months later, which is why I waited to show it, because I wanted to get both pieces, came Silver Surfer, reproducing that iconic cover. Just a totally awesome statue. And so, you know, when you look at it, oh man, that was awesome. My local toy store that sells comics could not get this in. I offered to buy it from him to give him the business, but he said he couldn't guarantee he could get that in. So I ended up purchasing it from an online toy store, and it took me several months to get it. Actually, probably 6 or 7 months when I ordered it, followed by, you know, the first one coming, and then the second one came. Silver Surfer, the Thor came first, and then Silver Surfer was released 1.5 months later. I don't know why they didn't release them together, but they didn't. And I just got them in the mail not too long ago. Probably 2-3 weeks ago. But anyhow, there you have it. Most of the statues, I do own quite a few statues that I've had, but most of my statues are DC. I don't really have any Marvel statues. This is probably my first set of Marvel statues. When I pre-ordered it, you know, each piece was, I think, a little bit over $170 plus tax and shipping. And, man, I couldn't be more pleased with them. So, anyway, I'm going to set some room aside on my shelf, and I'm going to put it up eventually in a permanent spot, and there it'll stay. Again, an iconic reproduction of the Silver Surfer number 4 cover. I think I've also shown in the past, on another video, I had gotten a homage reprint of this cover by Arthur Adams in black and white with his signature, and it was a great, great looking cover too. Or not even a cover, it was a poster that he signed. So, all right, so let's get started with the books. I think my son is going to join us this time again.
Hi.
Oh, hey, Max.
Hi.
He wanted to show us a couple of action figures that he's picked up during the pandemic. You want to show them now, Max?
Yeah, I guess so.
All right, what do we have here? Oh, yeah. I love this figure. This figure came out probably several years ago. It's a Marvel Legends. And it is Spider-Man Marvel Legends from the first appearance of Morbius, right? Yep. The six-arm Spider-Man, eight appendages, I guess, if you count the legs, like a spider. Awesome-looking figure there. All the arms articulate, which is cool. Very well done. And you can even see on the sides how, like in the comic book, they painted the costume stretching out and breaking out of the side of the body there, which I thought was a nice touch. You have another figure, Max, did you want to show?
Yep.
Oh, yeah. This was the Marvel Select Iron Man from Infinity War, where he is doing
snapping his fingers
with the Infinity Gauntlet. Great looking figure also. Nice figure. And Max has just recently watched all of the Avenger movies and all the MCU movies. And we're waiting to go see Black Widow soon. We've been watching Loki every week. He's watched Loki as well as Falcon and Winter Soldier. I don't know. Did you watch Scarlet Witch?
I think, yeah.
Yeah? And speaking of which, the Infinity Gauntlet. You may have heard that in the background. The Iron Man. Which is an also nice, cool toy by Marvel Legends that I've had. I've shown this before. Whoops. Man down.
I got it.
Well, thanks for sharing, Max.
You're welcome.
Okay. All right. So let's get started with some books now. All right. So, as I was saying in the before, I've been hunting a lot of books lately, and I'm going to show some of the things I've found. As I've mentioned many times before, Adam Hughes is my favorite cover artist. This is Witchblade number, what is this, 86. It's probably VF. A couple of spine ticks in it, but I got that for $1. I was going to leave that there. I think this is my 4th or 5th copy. You know, his Adam Hughes Witchblade covers are hard to find in the wild. So, if I find them in decent condition, I still pick them up. Alright, what else do I got here? Ultimates number 3, 2016. Got a little bit of heat on it. It's probably slowed down a little bit. You know, this is still, you know, an early appearance of America Chavez. This was a nice book. I found this, how much did I pay for that? I found this at an LCS. I want to say I paid less than $10 for this book, but it's in great condition. This is probably my 4th copy of that. I'm not sure why it was still in their back issues, but I paid less than $10 for this, and this is the Thing in the Guardians of the Galaxy, number 5, which is the second appearance of the Guardians of the Galaxy. And that's probably in this condition. This is probably a VF plus. Pages are sharp. They're still pretty white to off-white. The only thing that I would say would probably get dinged on is how there's too much white margin on the side here. There's no spine ticks. You know, color's real nice. The Marvel value stamp is still intact. And, you know, probably in this condition, that's probably a $40 book. So I'm glad to have gotten that. All right. What else am I going to show here? I'll show this because it's here and bagged. Star Wars Insider. Issue 201 with Boba Fett cover. Kind of nice. That just came out recently. Alright, some more dollar books. This is Astonishing X-Men number 51. Cover A. You know, that's... On some days, it can go for $10 to $15. There are a lot of listings for cover price. But there's still quite a few sales still at, you know, $10 to $15. So, glad to pick that up for a dollar. This is Quasar number 30 with a Greg Capullo cover. This is the first Venomized character of Thor. And that book is in their mint and for a dollar. And that will go for $20 pretty steadily. Now, this book I got, I did not know anything about it. I only paid 35 cents for it. And after I got it, you know, it was rare enough and it was something that I didn't know anything about. I know there are a lot of Spawn fanatics and it wasn't near mint. This is from 2008, The Adventures of Spawn number 2 for 35 cents, and that is probably a $20, you know, $15 easy, $20 book for, you know, trying to finish my run of Moon Girl and Devil Dinosaur. Some of the early issues. This is number 11 for 35 cents. Got these. Batman. Number 14. Stephanie Hans cover. Number 15. Also a nice looking Stephanie Hans cover. They don't really go for anything. But for 35 cents. You know. What are you going to do? Oh, do you want to show this comic, Max?
Well, I guess so.
Oh, okay. So, a few days... well, it's probably been a couple of months. We went to a store, LCS...
World's Greatest Comics.
World's Greatest Comics, that's right. And Max pulled out a dollar book out of the dollar bin. And this is Spider-Man City at War number 1. Great looking cover. So, that is his first comic...
It's not my first.
Yeah, it's your first comic that you picked from a store.
True.
Yes, first comic book that he has picked from a store. Spider-Man City at War. My first comic I ever got from a store that I bought, that I actually, my parents actually bought me, was an Atlas comic from Man Monster by Rick Butler. Buckler, that doesn't go for anything. So anyway, at least he's got a little bit better taste with Spider-Man. All right, back to more dollar. Here you go, Max. Put your book away there.
Thank you.
Uh-huh. All right, so then another dollar book. Back to dollar books. I got this Teen Titans number 43, which is the first appearance of this character here, Enigma. That is the Riddler's daughter. The new Teen Titans East. Here's a couple more 35 cent books I picked up. Moon Girl and the Devil Dinosaur number 4. It was in high grade near mint. So I picked up both of them that were there for 35 cent. That 35 cent. So like I said, I picked up a whole long box of books. Amazing Spider-Man 359. Wasn't sure if I had this book or not, but it was in high grade, so I picked that up. I don't know how many copies I have of this, but this is Night Stalkers number 1, still bagged and near mint. I think a lot of people are speculating that the next wave of MCU book movies are going to be in this kind of realm with Blade again, Ghost Rider, etc. coming out. All right. Now I got these two books for $2 a piece, which, you know, they don't go for a whole lot because there were so many printed. But for $2, Green Lantern number 50, glow-in-the-dark cover, first appearance of Parallax, as well as the first appearance of Kal Reiner as Green Lantern. So I got a direct sale for $2, and I got a newsstand for $2. And both the newsstand is actually in better condition. There's some spine ticks here. I think, yeah, they don't break color, but definitely the newsstand is a little bit better condition. Okay. Moving along. Oh, man. This comic here I bought for just nostalgia. It doesn't go for anything. But, you know, this was one of the movies that I saw in the theater. Me and my sister went. Hey, Google, resume play from beginning.
Nothing's playing right now.
Oh, man. Hey, Google, play Flash Gordon.
Playing the album Flash Gordon on YouTube Music.
Hey, Google, play Flash Gordon by Queen.
Flash, digital remaster by Queen. Sure. Playing on YouTube Music.
Look at this comic here. Does that bring back the 1980s? Flash Gordon, the movie adaptation, part one for 35 cents. That movie has grown on me over time. It wasn't a great movie. The soundtrack by Queen was obviously much better. But when I saw that, it was in pretty high grade. And I couldn't leave it there for 35 cents. I looked for the other parts. There's three parts to the movie adaptation. But I could only find part one. Hey, Google, cancel. Anyway, when I was bagging this book, I was playing that soundtrack. All right, so let's see. Got this for 35 cents. New Avengers number 54. Very fine. It's the first full appearance of Brother Voodoo as Sorcerer Supreme. A book that I noticed is hard to find in the wild in a dollar bins. And even actually, in my experience looking at LCSs, I don't find back issues of Volume 1 of Danger Girl in dollar bins or even in back issues. And so this is Danger Girl number 4 for 35 cents. So I picked that up. This is a beautiful cover by Josh Middleton. This is just in my pile of comics, and I did pay cover price for that. Beautiful cover, 765, cover B by Josh Middleton. Some more comics I got for 35 cents. I found another copy of Sam Wilson, Captain America number 18 and number 19, which is the first full appearance of Rayshon Lucas, who later becomes the new, I think he becomes the new Falcon. No, he becomes Patriot. That's who it is. Young Avengers number 1, volume 2. I think this is, paid a dollar for that, and that is a $20 book now. I love this cover here. Purple, third print. Savage Dragon 252. I did pay cover price. I think I paid a little bit less than cover price. Maybe $2.99 for these. $3. Cover price is $3.99. I think, you know, given some time, these may heat up. Champions number one, the Stan Lee tribute variant from 2018. I got three copies of that. I did pay $2 a piece for these. It was a half off sale, and so I believe cover price is $3.99. I have multiple copies of this cover, but I love the cover. This is definitely a cover buy. If I find it, it doesn't go for anything either, but if I find it for cheap and near mint, 35 cent, the dance or dance number three. I don't even know who these two characters are. The art germ has kissing, but it reminds me of, every time I see that, of the, gosh, what comic is that? It's the one where Catman is kissing. It's either Catwoman or Batgirl. I can't remember which cover that is, which series that is, but Catman is kissing someone. Now I'm going to have to go find that book and look. But if any of you know and want to mention it, but I know it's Catman, and I think he's kissing Catwoman or Batgirl, one of the two. But it was an art germ cover. That one goes probably about $8 to $10. But beautiful cover by Art Germ. So another 35 cent, Adam Hughes, Tomb Raider number 3. It wasn't bagged when I found it, so it's a little dirty on the cover that you can see even, you know, in the Mylar, this scuffing here. I'm not sure if you can clean it with some Absorbicell. But, you know, I just bought it to help complete my run. Now, they had more copies than I actually bought of this for 35 cent. I'd already had several copies that I bought when it came out. I like this cover, Invisible Woman number 2 by Adam Hughes, for 35 cent a piece. I figured 3 copies for $1 was worth it. Batgirl number 4, great Adam Hughes cover. And Batgirl number 5, also Adam Hughes, all in near mint. And these two I did pay $1 a piece. Okay. Moving along. What else do I have? Now, these books I have not put in Mylar, but the Old Guard Netflix movie I thought was pretty well done. I like that movie, even though it didn't get great ratings, but I did like that movie. I didn't even realize it was a comic book till after the fact when I saw the credits. And when I saw Greg Rucka, you know, had been doing this, I was like, oh, that's a comic book. And so then I looked it up and I saw, oh, yeah, it was. So, you know, I wasn't on the hunt for these books at that time when probably the news broke that it was getting optioned. And so I've been gradually, when I see them in dollar bins, I pick them up. So far, I have number 3 and number 4 that I picked up for $1. Now, I do know that 1 through 4, the set, I don't know if the limited series was 1 through 5, maybe, can go for a little bit of money. But for $1, I was going to leave those there. Sonata, number 3, for 35 cent. I got this for also 35 cent. Savage Avengers, number 4. Champions, number 8. Sensational Spider-Man number 1, all for 35 cent. I got this for 35 cent, and it was not bagged. I mean, I should take it back. It was still in the poly bag, but it was opened. And I don't think I realized that when I got it. But when I rebagged it, because I can't stand it when they're in their original bags from the store, they're all dirty and stuff. This was opened already. But it was still in near mint. It was unsealed, but the poster was still inside. So that's, you know, so I kept it in the poly bag and rebagged it in another bag. I got this for 35 cents. The only reason why I got it was because I know I'm missing some of this Extension Agenda storyline. I couldn't remember which ones are missing, but I think it might have been X-Factor, may have been one. So I picked that up for 35 cents. I really should do something better about figuring out which books I don't have. There's another, the other series that I don't... I don't really know. I'm trying to go by memory if I have the comic or not. There's three series I'm trying to complete, or storylines: Extension Agenda, The Messiah Complex, and Maximum Carnage. And I'm always picking up books that I already have, and who knows, this probably was another scenario. I did get this. I've mentioned this before. Anytime I see high grade Uncanny X-Men from the 90s, particularly Jim Lee or Mark Silvestri artwork, I'm picking it up. So this was 35 cents, pretty still, you know, high grade book. So, you know, like I said, I'm picking those books up. What else? Oh, all right. Now, I'll show this just because I have it bagged. Department of Truth variant cover number 6. This here for 35 cents. This was a VF copy. Daredevil number 250 of volume 1. First appearance of Bullet. Daredevil 272. This was a VF plus, which is the first appearance of Shotgun. Those are 35 cents. This is also 35 cents in high grade, 251. And then 275 with Ultron on the cover. Okay. I just got these this past weekend when I was out of town. Now, this is probably the best Justice League cover, Justice League America cover that Adam Hughes did. That's, you know, it can get a little bit of heat. You know, shops are now, you know, onto it, kind of classic. You know, Adam Hughes female cover. I used to find this quite regularly in the dollar bins, but I haven't been finding this as much anymore. And so I came across this. This is probably just VF. It's got a few issues on the spine. I don't know if you can tell. They don't break color, but they're there. And I got that for a dollar. Now that I'm seeing LCS's having it on their wall for like, you know, $5 to $8. This has a little heat on here, 272. I think it's future Nathan Richards. I got this because it's just a great cover by Greg Horn, whether you like him or not. That's Emma Frost number 5. And Emma Frost, which I have several copies of that, but I did not have this one. Emma Frost number 6. Those I did pay $1 a piece for. And then I got this, was in high grade. This is a great cover, great storyline. Wolverine number 90, volume 1 of his ongoing series. Great comic for $1. Found this for $1, which, and I only picked that up because it had Brother Voodoo in it, and it was in really high grade. the thing in Brother Voodoo number 41 for $1. We're at 30 minutes here, so I think I'm going to stop there. Try to get my thoughts together and get another group of books to show. Appreciate your time. And I guess I'm going to leave it at that and sign off with an image of Mario looking at the cosmic cover from Silver Surfer number 4. Anyway, say bye, Max.
Bye.
Peace.